Documentation, technology, tool stack, installation architecture, challenges, ways, future enhancements. Okay, so it's not much. So brief synopsis can include challenges, issues, background in short. Okay, background they want. So let's so this can be background is we are doing a project, right? Challenge one, right? No, challenge two. So the challenge is to build a virtual wallet service. This service can be used by gaming companies to manage players' account balances, including virtual currencies. The following AWS could be leveraged to demonstrate the diseases. Okay. So if you all have any questions, you'll let me. You can stop me and ask me. Problem means add a brief on the problem that you're solving. Can include in scope, out of scope areas as per statement. So this we can say specifically we refer to a particular CDK. Have they asked for architecture diagram anyway? Okay, solution architecture. So your problem being solved. Add a brief, can include in scope, out of scope, right? So this right, so in scope, out of scope, again this is there inside your document. This is what we're going to say. This is the scope. Oh, what is the font size? What font we have copied? This font is good. What is this font? Format, character, Warden or regular 18, okay. Okay, they have, what is this font? Warden or regular 18, okay. So let's make it Warden or regular 18. So this looks a little neat. So then we format it a little bit, and can we take it on top? Get ones, get transaction history, you know. Also. I don't know whether we want to specify get and all this because these two are not working get funds. So what is working we'll put first, I think. Create account is working. So I've already demonstrated how this thing works. So I think in case of Croydon and Deepak, if you all are doing this, even Anuradha, you all will need help from somebody in the class who has done it. So we have already gone through this over the week, whoever has participated. Get funds and add funds should be the second fellow, no? So before we withdraw, we have to add. Same principle applies. Oh, it has to be, it's followed. Withdraw funds, it is talking about. So create account. To start a transaction, select the current amount and remove the requested if they're available because the code will run inside the PV. It is not possible for another process to modify the amount while the transaction is running. We don't want to complicate this, otherwise I'm going to ask you questions on this. So create account will create a new document in QLDB only if it doesn't exist. All transactions all fund transactions will be associated with some account number. Will display the list of all transactions associated with the account. Now, since this is like taking a lot of page, ideally, I would have made it very simple and small and one-liner description, but we can think about it later, okay? So, whether we want to do with that. Okay. Okay, what is the next one? Technology stack. So technology stack we know, no? This is the technology stack. Okay, and six, we are also creating a website, right? So HTML, CSS, and whatever you're using, Angular, JS, and maybe Postman. So this became your technology stack. Solution architecture, we already have a diagram, right? So that will be the diagram. Sorry, where it is? Should be there here, no? assume little less, is it? Can we go to this link and get the image? We should have downloaded that architecture image. Project 2 round 1, no, not, no. Yeah, it is project 2 round 1. This is the link, no? Image address, paste it over here. And actually I want to show that right inside HTML. That's why I want to have need this diagram. So save image as documents wallet service. So this entire folder is going to, okay, I have copied it over here already. So what I mean to say, this entire folder will be uploaded in GitHub, okay? So that's how my code. So since I already have this diagram, I'll forget about this. And is there in wallet service now? Yep. This fellow I'll open in paintbrush, edit with paint, edit with photos, edit. So this opens up. And let me just make it a little big and let me shift it a little bit in this right hand side. And I don't have that icon for browser, but so you have a browser and you need an arrow key. I think I should have drawn this. So I hope we have already gone through this diagram. My videos are on yeah, I think some of them are unlisted. The wallet service is unlisted because somebody saw my Capgemini SageMaker thing and they approached me. Somebody I don't know. So so this time I received a message. You know, you always see on the YouTube the comment. He's saying, "Dude, help me." So I was wondering what is that? I don't know what kind of greeting was that. Okay, so architecture, what we want to do is we want to copy this diagram over here. Briefly explain the solution. Okay, briefly explain. They want us to explain also, but why are they asking for diagram then? This will be two diagrams, no? Okay, let's see. Users will create account, add funds, withdraw funds, get fund to see balance and get transaction history. From the browser AngularJS code will use asynchronous, this is going to be not look good actually. Okay, so any questions so far? Anyone? Can somebody just get on the speaker and tell me? Crichton, are you understanding anything?
I'm trying to understand.
Okay. Priscilla, can you quickly explain what is there in this diagram? I can maybe make it big. Is a layout. How to make it big?
Sir, can you make it a little more big?
Yeah, I'm just trying to make it big. Hold on. Yeah, just can you explain quickly? Whoever is known, have not understood this diagram. Can you explain what is happening?
Yes, sir. So this is like a virtual wallet service. So the first thing is like, I'm sorry, sir, I might be wrong somewhere, but I'll just explain as per my understanding. So it's like there is a QLDB wallet database where the tables are stored, like in the form of account ID or along with a specific ID and a balance. So that data is sent to Kinesis data stream. So Kinesis data stream is where it streams the data. Huge number of data is stored, and then there is a Lambda service called streaming insert into, and then it goes to DynamoDB transaction history. Transaction history means it shows all the history of all the transaction that happened from the start till the current state. In the middle, there are different Lambda services. So basically, before we go to the Lambda service, there is an API gateway. This API gateway, we have different methods in that. So when we select any method, we can check as per our requirement. When we select post method, it also gives us the information. So with regards to API gateway, the first information is get transaction history. So when we insert get transaction history, it will show us all the transaction history. Create wallet, this Lambda function helps in creating a new wallet information, that is like an account information. And so in between, we have an option like create wallet that will connect with create wallet Lambda function. Then there is another information as add funds amount. When we use this function, if we want to add more funds, like a balance in that, we can add that. Then withdraw amount, like we are withdrawing the money. So for and get funds. So I'm not sure about get funds. And apart from that, this is like a browser HTML, CSS, and okay. So yesterday, sir was showing this postman. So it's like either we can check the once we create a EC2 machine, and once we do the deployment using PuTTY, later we can check the QLDB table along with that API gateway. So either we can go to the table and check the information, or we can use Postman's application, and we can mention that account ID and run it and check what all services are running. Yes, sir.
Okay, Croydon, can you explain what Priscilla tried to explain? What did you understand?
I understood that first I need to create some tables and name it as wallet database, in which I need to make 5 tables probably, these orange ones, and then I need to connect it with the API.
So the thing is, so this is for everyone. When you all are, this is the first thing, you know, when you all are giving a demo, you all need to explain the architecture. Now, so when you're explaining the architecture, I don't know how, so let me explain it and maybe you all can use my technique or something, you know, so I'll explain again, you know, everything to Croydon, and then Croydon, let me know, you know, what you understand from this. So what basically a wallet service is like, you have a wallet, and you know, so wallet is like creating an account, right? Creating a wallet means if you are buying a wallet and putting it in your pocket, you know, that is like creating an account. Then you, when you want to, you cannot withdraw any money from your wallet, right? First you have to put some money. So every time you have some cash, you put it into the account. So that, so create wallet is the step. Is a lambda is nothing but a functionality, and it's a code written in Java or Node.js, and in our case it is written in Python language. So create wallet is the duty of the create wallet function, or the code is to create a wallet for you, and it gives a particular ID for you. This is Croydon's wallet, this is Priscilla's wallet, and once the wallet is created, then we want to add money. So add funds is used for that. So we say Croydon's wallet, I want 100 rupees to be put. Priscilla's wallet, I want 200 rupees to be put. And withdraw fund functionality, what it will do, it will so every time somebody adds the funds, the balance will increase, right, from 0 to 100. And withdraw funds is a reverse operation, right? Whenever you ask this lambda function to withdraw fund, it will take that wallet and remove something, money, out of it. And get fund is to know the balance of the fund. So it is like get fund balance. It is get funds means it's like confusing at first, but when I saw the output, I realized they're just giving you the balance amount. So get funds is like looking for account balance. And get transaction history is telling you the history. Today I put 100 rupees, then tomorrow I remove 20 rupees, and day after tomorrow I again put another 40 rupees. So it's a list of all the transactions that is happening. So it is very simple operations that you normally operate in wallet, and that is what with you, you do with any wallets, right? Paytm wallet or any wallets. And this whenever so if you have used Paytm on everything or GPay, behind the scene the wallet is running. So GPay will have your own, you have a GPay wallet, you have a Paytm wallet. In the gaming also we have wallets where people are playing with money, right? So that is why everybody has a wallet, and they say, okay, I take on this challenge, and it's like a gambling, you know. So the wallet service is quite a bit of things in action these days. You can play with direct money also. So all these functionalities have been implemented, and where, what is the database that has been used? That is, it is ledger has been used. Ledger is in accounting world. Anybody knows what is a ledger, right? It is a book where you put your transaction in. And the thing is, why we are using a ledger, you know, first of all, it is a ledger database, means it is tuned for to work like a ledger, you know. So you just keep on putting entries and everything, and also a lot of data is coming in because millions of people may be playing the games, or 10,000 people are playing the games, each one has their own wallet. So there's a lot of data to be dealt with. So the first thing, whenever anybody does implements, So anybody, so 10,000 or million people may, from the left hand side, they are playing games over here on the browser, on the mobile. This can be mobile also, right? Mobile browser. They're playing games. So every time they're playing games, they are dealing with a wallet over here. So so whenever, yeah, so all those transactions are flowing in like a flood, like a flood of data is coming from the left hand side, and all that flood is getting accumulated in this fellow over here. So this fellow then he says, oh, okay, I'll show the entry, but let Kinesis handle this. Kinesis is like a flood handler. It's like a dam. So you have a big flood coming from the, let's say, flowing through the mountain. So you need a, and it will, you know, it will destroy everything on the way. Your data will be lost, or your memory will be full. You know, your hard disk may be full. So your machine will stop, you know, can stop working in case if there's too much of data, right? Your memory is only limited. We are working with limited resources. So Kinesis data stream is a service which is used to handle real-time data streaming. So the real time is very important, because on the left hand side, data is getting generated in real time. It is not like between 2 and 4 you generate the data, then between 4 and 5 I will take the data and, you know, batch it and process it, and then So it is like real time. It's like it's online right now. It is happening right now. If I put 100 rupees, I should see 100 rupees in my account, right? So whenever anybody clicks on the Facebook, you know, so Facebook wants to know how many people are clicking what type of data. So you can understand, so many clicks are happening, so many different types of data is getting clicked, so much of so all that information has to be pulled in, and it's like a flood of information. It's like big data coming in. And to handle a big data, the first thing that anyone has to do is use real-time data streaming. Means definitely it will have a technology to manage, you know, break down the data, maybe use parallel computing. I don't know, maybe Kinesis. We have to look into Kinesis, how Kinesis manages this. So but definitely the input for the Kinesis is a flood of data. It's like big data, you push it into Kinesis, and from the Kinesis, once it will basically ensure that none of your data is lost. And it can handle the velocity of the data, it can handle the variety of the data. There's a 6 V's of big data, right? So velocity, variety, veracity, volume. So Kinesis, you know, is most like is kind of designed to handle maybe not maybe big data plus real time also. There are two aspects of it, not only big data. So big data would mean only I'm handling, I can you know, take the data and put it into batches also, and then process it later. That's what banks do, right? Banks say, okay, you deposit the money, but it will reflect on your passbook tomorrow or three days later. So what they are trying to do, they are collecting all the transactions and they're putting it into something like QLDB kind of thing. Okay, I will, you give it to me, then I will pass it on to, then at one particular time, Kinesis will, you know, take all, connect to QLDB and process all the data and eventually put it into DynamoDB. So your DynamoDB has all the records in the end. So that's why anytime anyone wants to know what is the transaction history, they're contacting directly to the DynamoDB. They're not contacting QLDB. QLDB is more of a transactional database, and DynamoDB is more like a read-only database. Okay, here we are not writing any information into the DynamoDB. To Dynamo, because it's a read-only database, it is faster, and you can duplicate this DynamoDB very easily across different regions. So so browser is a place where we perform all our operations, and the first thing browser does is contacts the API, because this is like your watchman. So basically we don't want to expose any of our services, whatever is inside the system. So whatever you want to do on AWS, always use a API gateway in the, as a doorman. Now just because there is one door, it does not mean there is only one door. API gateway is very intelligent. If there are 10,000 browsers on the left hand side, like 10,000 people playing on the left hand side, API gateway will multiply itself. It can duplicate itself. That is an internal mechanism of API. So the API can handle you know, that load, and it can multiply. So but it is a doorway, okay? It has got no functionality of its own. It is just a function call, but it is handling all that function call. And if there is any attack on your website API gateway is will handle it. Will it is easier to manage this door rather than letting them everybody in and play around with your functionality. So once the API gateway gives you the permission in, the API gateway first says which function are you want to perform. So in API gateway we have there are five functions implemented as Priscilla said. And depending on which function they want to implement, they want to create a wallet, it knows it has to contact this Lambda function. So this Lambda is nothing but a code, right? Which will create a wallet for you. And this Lambda function, what it does internally, okay, it takes the information from the browser and says, I want to create account number, whatever, and it stores in the QLDB over here. And QLDB, what it does, it takes the flood of all the information and pushes it through the Kinesis data stream, which ultimately gets saved in DynamoDB. And if the user wants to see get transactions of his wallet transaction, user says give me for this particular account number, give me the transaction. So API gateway will go to this Lambda function, who is responsible to contact the DynamoDB and get the data. So this is what the architecture is. So Croydon, can you tell me what you understood from this diagram?
It's like a give and take system where the I got confused in this Kinesis data stream. Does it work like a load balancer?
It can, it may. Kinesis is real time data streaming. Real time data streaming means I'll tell you, for example, real time, lot of things happen in real time, right? On the net. You upload a photo, you click a photo, that is real time data. So how many, if you want to know which users have clicked what is the total number of users who are clicking Facebook at right now this moment, you think? So Croydon, I'm asking that question. How many users are clicking some photo on a some photo inside the Facebook right now, or how many people are uploading a photo at this moment? Ryden, you can hear me?
Yes, sir.
So there are, you can easily think, no, it is like 7 billion population, half the people have internet, just calculate 25%, so at least 1 billion people are clicking something on the Facebook. Can you assume that? Out of 7 billion people on this earth, at least 1 billion people are doing something with Facebook or Instagram right now. Not sure. So the idea is lot of data is getting generated in 1 second, okay? And to handle, so that kind of data is called real-time data. And every second, it is not like somebody is clicking now and then next second nobody is clicking. Every second, 50, maybe 500 lakhs hits are happening. Something is happening on the website, okay? There are a lot of clicks happening on the website. So it is called click streaming. That kind of real-time streaming is called click streaming. So if you're dealing with data, then Kinesis is one of the helper services, okay? So it is real-time data streaming. So we'll have to read about what is real-time data streaming for that. But you understood what we are trying to achieve, what is a wallet service?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let me not spend too much time now on this. We have to finish the documentation. You've just joined very recently, right, into the challenge, and that's why. What is this prototype video MVP? Yeah, so this you want to paste your recording over, paste your video recording link. So you need to record your demo and put it over here, and you have to explain everything in the video, okay? So maybe you can put the link and it like put it like a window, you know, so that when they click on it and so if you say insert audio video and then you maybe can provide a link or something or maybe you can download your video or whatever it, or it may be embedded, I do not know, something you do. Challenges face, any technological challenge you faced in devising the solution, how would you solve them? What technological challenge we have faced? Actually, no big challenges as such, right? But if you do say no big challenges, then they'll think we know everything. Any technological challenge? What we can put here? Anybody? Any idea? What technology challenge?
So we can put like on our local deploy when we were locally deploying, it wasn't deploying easily. That source code we got from GitHub.
Very
So
good.
we installed Docker and all those EC2 instances. We can mention all that here.
Very good, very good. So you can say so initially we used a CDK stack. So in the bracket you can say cloud development kit stack. We downloaded the CDK stack on local box and tried to create CDK stack to create the wallet service architecture components on local from the local box. We know this English is wrong. We downloaded the CDK stack on local box to create, so this has to be comma maybe, to create the wallet service architecture components on AWS cloud. But lot of softwares we realized that lot of softwares were required to make the CDK work. We installed Git, Python 3.8, then what else? Docker, and what else? NPM, so Node.js. And anything else we installed?
No, sir.
We installed on low and CDK, yeah, AWS CDK, CDK Python library we did install on local box. But
Sir,
then
putty.
PuTTY, very good. PuTTY.
Sir, bootstrap.
Bootstrap, that you put in your case because we in our case we didn't use, no? In my case I didn't use. You use Bootstrap, is it?
Yes, sir.
Ah, so you who is speaking? Actually I don't know. Yeah, so whatever softwares you all use, no, you all mention over here on local box. But then once CDK started working, it was trying the whole, it was trying to upload at least 500 MB size data, which took lot of time. If there was any error post deployment, the whole process had to be repeated from local box again. This technique used 3 to 4 hours per deployment cycle. To solve this problem, I'm using we everywhere. Oh, it's okay. We can say we, maybe I don't know. I have to use I only because you're going in as an individual, right? Spelling mistake, data, if there was an error, the whole process is, this technique requires. To solve this problem, I created EC2 Linux t2.large machine on AWS and carried out the deployment process. The deployment time was reduced to approximate 1 hour, and this such a change in solution helped us be more productive, gave us more productive time to test and resolve, test the actual architecture on AWS and resolve all pressing technical problems. I think this is good enough. I like this, huh? Palak, very good, excellent. See, this is the benefit of working in teams. Somebody's strength helps you with your weakness. Your strength helps somebody else's weakness. So we all win. Okay, so this is challenges faced. So in the interview, they may ask you what are the other challenges. They may get impressed by this and they may say, okay, any other challenge you faced? And so think of some challenges if you have, and if you don't have, then you can always, what is this? Future enhancements. Very good. What can the future enhancements be? Anyone any idea? How can you enhance this program further?
Hello, sir.
Yeah, hello.
So we can add user authentication. Right now, what you showed yesterday, you can put account ID on your own. So it can cause error in the database. Like I can enter 123. So that doesn't represent anything unique. So we can install.
So I can say account numbers, new account numbers will be generated automatically. Instead of
when user is authenticated, then only he can create account.
So you can say, first of all, user authentication is not there, so you can include user register users and user registration, right? I'm just using we can create a user registration service to control who can use the wallet service. Is that okay, Palak?
Yes, sir. So we can also add if we use this user authentication.
admin and a normal user service. Like admin can access all the account state, all the account IDs. Like he cannot write or delete anything, but he can view what all transaction other users are doing, if they are a legal transaction or illegal transaction, to control the authenticity, I guess.
Okay, so we have an admin panel basically.
Yes, sir.
So an admin panel can be introduced to manage the to ensure can be introduced to what is it Palak? To resolve issues, any issues to receive an address any issues reported by the users. Is this okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, how do I do this now? This is too big. And you said one more thing, no? What is that you said? What did you say? Unique account numbers, no? So this fellow, oh, this goes like this. How does this work?
Hello?
Yeah.
Sir, it will be involved in user registration only. When user will register, it will generate the account number.
Ah, okay. Whatever. Okay, so let's put that. Any other you think should include?
Sir, I don't have any other idea right now.
Okay, no problem. Even two you put. Now, we just want to put something for, you know, they are either solid two. I don't want to change anything. You know, just to make them happy. Okay, they've asked for it. So we create a user registration service, and account numbers can be auto-generated instead of user typing it. Okay, this is very impressive. Hey, why this went away? I did undo, no? Admin panel. An administrator can receive an address all issues reported by the users. Okay, so let us keep this much. But when you all are giving your interview, you all may have let's keep. So see, my presentation is done, so at least I have something to offer, no? That is a good thing. I think I can make this 18 now. Hopefully it will not go beyond. If it does, oops. So new document is like a new record, okay? This is most likely a non-SQL database. So that's why it says document, it doesn't say record. If it is a SQL database, it will say new record. How small can I make this? It's 18, so let's try 17. 17 is better now. Okay, so this is the presentation is ready. So I will pass this presentation to everyone. Only means those who are, you know, into round two, those who have shown me round two, only for, you know, so unless so I'll be asking this question later, but right now let me stop the recording. So this wallet.py, it deploys your serverless wallet, and it starts with a QLDB ledger. You know, it creates a ledger over here. This is the syntax, and if you notice, AWS underscore QLDB is a QLDB Python library, and that is the library we have to install using pip3. So if you notice the import over here, we are using all this AWS code. This is a Python code actually written for AWS specifically. So we have to need this libraries to make thing to programmatically do everything from your Python code. So QLDB is installed, then DynamoDB is a table is created over here, which is a managed database, and then we attach some permissions and policies so that, you know, so remember QLDB is been updated by Lambda function. So Lambda functions also have to be given permissions to write to QLDBs, and that is what is happening in all this code over here. They are giving permissions, so no service can touch another service without giving permissions. And then here you actually create your function get funds lambda, and so whatever name you give, that name function with that name will be created. So we are not changing any names, and all these functions of lambda functions will be created. We have already seen around five six lambda functions which is getting created over here. Then the Kinesis streams have been created. If you want to study how Kinesis data stream works, then you have to dig down. You have to study real-time data streaming. Maybe sometime in future, we can have a separate session for real-time data streaming. And this Lambda deployment process is still going on. And finally, the entire deployment gets over. So it tries to create a table, an index. So it says execute the below queries. So this fellows, this part is has to be done manually because it did not work for us. No, we have to create it manually. So whatever, but otherwise everything gets deployed, and finally, so this is nothing but it is calling this function serverless wallet, this fellow. This is a definition of the class, but here it is actually calling the function. And apps in this doing something which I'm not very sure, but this is if you want to know how to write CDK code, use this as a reference. In future if you want to create your own CDK code, use this as a reference. Okay, so one should be able to so even though you're getting into cloud, if you're into any administration work in the cloud, everything works as a code. So remember this, infrastructure is a code, IaaS we say. So infrastructure, you don't go there and create any machine, you're not touching any machine, but programmatically you should be able to control from here, or you should be able to go to console and create machine. So programmatically, if you want to create a machine, you have to come here and write some programs using some AWS library. So that is all that you're going to talk about deployment. You're not going to show them the deployment because it is going to take long time. Maybe you can go on AWS and show them something like, you know, say I have a machine over here. So let me go to AWS. Where is AWS?